let go. Let God. Oh, let go. Let God. Let go. And let God. My brother, let go. And let God. My sister, you can't handle it. Let God.
We serve. cry it out. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Glory! Hallelujah! I'm going to tell you what today. Glory! The way out is praising Him. The way out is lift your head up, lifting your hands up, lifting your spirit up. Hallelujah. Everything about God is up. Everything about the enemy's down. You got to find out what direction you're going. I'm telling you today, hallelujah, you can have the worst day in this world, but still have a good day in the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm going to tell you what. Oh, when you lift your hands anyway, and you lift your voice anyway, hallelujah, that lets hell know you ain't going to win hell. You ain't going to win hell. You're not going to win. Praise the Lord. How many times we heard the enemy tell us, well, you ain't worthy enough. I'm going to tell you what, you're right, devil. I'm not worthy enough, but I know the one that's worthy. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. And I'm going to tell you, when you lift your hands anyway, oh, when you praise God anyway, anyway, anyway. Do we got anyway praise today? Do we got anyway, anyway, anyway? I'm broke, but I still praise Him. Oh, hallelujah. Car broke down, but I still praise Him. Hallelujah, my God. The greatest way to get things turned around, let's get your hands back in the air. Hallelujah. Paul and Silas had a bad day. If anybody had an excuse why not to do what they did. But you know what? They realized one thing. My way out is up. And they began to lift their hands. And they began to pray. And they began to sing. And now I want you to know the very prison the enemy had for them couldn't hold them. I'm going to tell you today, if you'll start praising the God, things can't hold you back. Enemy can't hold you back. Sickness can't hold you back. Depression can't hold you back. I'm going to tell you, the enemy can't. Hallelujah. The only power the enemy has is when somebody's down. But I'm going to tell you why, when you're up. When I'm coming up, I'm coming up, I'm coming up, I'm coming up. I want you to lift your hands today. I want you to ask God, help me today. I want to break out of my prison today. I want to break out of that prison the enemy's trying to put me in. I want to break out of them chains today. I want victory today. I want liberty today. I want joy today. I want happiness. I want to laugh today. I want to rejoice today. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise God. Let's worship with them today.
Magnify the Lord and bless His name. Spend the door, the King of Kings. All the people shout and sing His praise. He's the mighty God. Jesus is the one who died for us. Jesus shed His blood just for us. Open up your mouth and shout aloud. He's the mighty God. Magnify the Lord and bless His name. Worship and adore the King of Kings. Forever, mighty and powerful. His name. Worship and adore the King of Kings. All the people shout and sing His praise. He is a mighty God. Jesus is the one who died for us. Jesus shed His blood just for us. Open up your mouth and shout aloud. He's a mighty God.
I thought what the Bible said about the prodigal son. The Bible said he came to himself. For him to come to himself, he must have been thinking something else. And I felt like God told me a while ago, people are being defeated here. They're being defeated right here. That they can't get victory here. I'm going to tell you today, listen. The Bible said he came. Once he came to himself, the pig pen couldn't hold him any longer. Past couldn't hold him any longer. Everything the enemy had couldn't hold him any longer because he came to himself. And I want you to know today, I feel like somebody's in this building today and your mind's being tormented by the enemy. You're tormented by the past. You're tormented. But I want you to know today, God wants to give you the right mind. God wants to give you the right mind. God wants to give you the right mind. Hallelujah. You will not be a victim, but you will be victorious. Hallelujah. He came to himself and he said, I know my Father's got more than this. I'm going to tell you, life, if you're not careful, the enemy will use it and put you in a pig pen. And you'll spend years fighting between what's here when that's really not the battle. Because if you'll make your mind up, there ain't a devil There ain't a spirit. There ain't a situation. There ain't a problem. Hallelujah. Listen, they're fixing to throw Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in the fire. And listen, if anything gonna change your mind, somebody's throwing you in a fire. But you know what? The world put pressure and told him, listen, when you hear our music, when you hear our music, I want you to bow down. I want you, you see, that's what the enemy wants you to bow down to his stuff. Bow down. But you know what? Shadrach, Meshach, had their mind made up. It don't matter what you do, oh king. Oh, hallelujah. We done got our mind made up. We done got our mind made up. We done got our mind made up. Hallelujah. Oh. Oh, I'm going to tell you what. Oh, the power of a made-up mind. The power of the power. You see, that's why the Bible said that God's not an author of confusion. If you sit here confused and don't know who you are, what you are, and what you can be, and you sit here confused and wonder why you're not happy and why you don't. Listen. The Bible said that the enemy blind the minds. The enemy wants to hide what God's got from you for you today. I want you to lift your hands. I tell you, in this place today, prison doors can be open. Chains can fall off. Life can be changed. You might have walked in here like the world has got its last pull down on you, but you're going to walk out of here with heaven pulling on you today. A change, a change, a change, a change, a change, a change. What a mighty God. What a mighty God. Why don't you let that mighty God be mighty for you right now? Why don't you let that mighty God, hallelujah, I'm going to tell you what, oh, hallelujah, don't sit for years with prison in your mind. Come on. Let this mind be in you, which also is in Christ. Get the right kind of mind today. Hallelujah. I'm going to tell you what. I am a winner. I am an overcomer. I am victorious. I'm not a loser. Hallelujah. I got joy. I got peace. Hallelujah. I am somebody. I'm made by God. Hallelujah. You know what? It's not enough to sing about it. You can sing songs and never believe what the song says. But when you lift your hands and you to let God know, listen, you're mighty and I need you to be mighty for me today. I'm tired of being unhappy. I'm tired of always feeling down and blue and struggling. You are the mighty God. You are the Prince of Peace. Your word said you came to give life, and I want that life. I want that life. I want that life today. I want life. I want to live. I want to smile. I want to rejoice. I want to sing. I want to be happy. I want to be complete. I want to be satisfied. Have you ever wondered why drugs are so widely spread and booze so widely spread? I tell you why it is. Because everybody's looking for something. But they're just looking in the wrong place. If beer and drugs could do it, they'd be the most happiest people there is. But I'm going to tell you, all it does is keep blinding. Depending on things that's not real. That's why the Lord was so upset about people at cistern wells. You see, cistern wells isn't a fresh well. Cistern wells are just a hole and not a real well. And that woman sitting on a well, he told her, listen, you're drinking from a well, but it's not the one you really need to drink from. It's not the really one. You're finding temporary satisfaction, but you got to find eternal satisfaction. I want you to find somebody to pray with right now. We're in no hurry. I want you to go pray with somebody. Hallelujah. I'm going to tell you what, some have been sitting on a well for a long time. You're sitting on a well, and you feel so dry, and you feel so empty, and you don't know what to do, and don't know which way to turn, and don't want to, what am I going to do? What am I going to do? What am I going to do? God, we sing about your might. I want you to be mighty in me. I want you to change me today. I want you to touch me today. I want you to break some chains in my life today. I want you to open that prison for me today. I want to get up, Lord. I want to get up out of that pig pen. I'm tired. I'm tired. I'm tired. My Lord, I know where to go. I'm going to Daddy's house. I'm going home. 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 I know where I belong. I'm going home. And he got up. And he didn't stop till he got where he needed to be. Come on, church, come on. Come on, some of you, you might not be at Daddy's house right now. Come on. Come on, you might not be where you want to be right now. Keep on walking. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I know you're tired, but keep on walking. I know you're weary, but keep on walking. He's a mighty God. He's looking for you. He's looking for you. He's looking for you. It might be over the next hill. He's looking for you. He's waiting for you. He knows. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. What a mighty God.
Before the power and the presence of the great I am.
Don't let your mind defeat you today. Don't let your mind defeat you today. Sometimes the enemy gets strongholds in our minds. And we can believe a lie. I think of Jacob. Spent all those years thinking his son was dead. But he was alive. And sometimes people spend years believing something the enemy said when it's not so. That's when they told him his son's still alive. He almost died. Couldn't believe it. You know, just because the enemy shows you something doesn't mean it's real. Telling you today, the enemy tries to tell you something's real and it ain't real. Anything that is negative, anything that is negative and tear you down is not of God. What mother, what child, daddy would put negative things in their children? Everything about my God says you can. All things are possible. Greater he that's in you than he that's in the world. Don't you think it's time to get your helmet on? The helmet covers the mind, and the mind controls your body. So goes your mind, so is your body. I had a neighbor. She went to the doctor. Doctors told her she had lupus. And so having lupus, she got out and learned all about lupus and all the symptoms of lupus and what lupus is. And before you know it, she found herself bedridden. She went to another doctor. And the doctor looked at all the tests and things. I said, I don't know who told you got lupus, but you ain't got it. She went from bedridden to putting in her in-ground pool, doing everything. Why I'm saying that today is you spend years being crippled in your mind. And the enemy says you got this and you got that. And so you start living up to the symptoms. You start living up to the symptoms because you already accept what the enemy says. That's why when somebody begins to get a hold of God and they start getting their life turned around, they take on the other symptoms and their life changes. He's a mighty God. But as mighty as God is, if he can't get it in your head, he's not mighty to you. I walked into a church 30-something years ago, broken, suicidal, lost, depressed, sick, taking pain pills that sold for $100 a piece on the street, wearing a back brace I've been wearing for 2 years, and a miserable young man at 27. Wasn't who I was. I found out who I was. I'm a king's kid. My daddy owns the cattle of 1,000 hills, and the hills are cattle. He brought me out to bring me in. So you're sitting here today. Maybe life ain't been fair. You know, it doesn't matter what life offers you. It's what you do with what life you have. I've heard it all my life. You can take lemons and make lemonade. You can take prunes and make a prune cake. Turn things around. Praise the Lord. Turn it around today. I want you to lift your hands as Brother Lawrence comes up today. Children's church can be dismissed. Appreciate all our children. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to his mighty name. You see, in every one of us today, we have the will to do right or the will to do wrong. We do. We have a choice. You can be happy or you can be sad. You can have peace or you can have torment. You can. The choice is in our hands. What did God told Moses to do? The enemy is at his back. He's blocked in a canyon, and the Red Sea is before him. Moses could have said, God, you led us out here to kill us. But you know what God told Moses? Use what you got in your hand. He had it in his hand all the time. And it's in your hands today to choose how you live. It's in your hands today to choose if you're going to be committed or not committed. Hot or cold or lukewarm. It's your choice. You gotta get the mind made up. Yeah. I want you to lift your hands one more time today. He said, I know the thoughts I have for you. I know the things I want to give you. Hallelujah. Oh my God, somebody could have a life-changing experience right now. Somebody could walk out of that pig pen, and everything that enemy's done for years against you will have to stay in the pig pen. You walk out of it, hallelujah. My Lord, daddy's got a new robe for you. Daddy's got a new robe for you. He's got new robe for you. Take out that robe of depression and put on that robe of joy. Hallelujah. Garments of praise. Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. What are you talking about, Brother Lambert? I'm talking about that mighty God. Sister Becky, I'm talking about that mighty God. Hallelujah. You've been knocking on that door, knocking on that door, knocking on that door. Open that door up today. Open all the, kick it off the hinges. Kick it off the hinges. Come on in. My. You know, when you take steps to get a hold of God, God sees that. God honors it. Praise God. Hallelujah. Oh, you see, too many people want to wait till they get saved before they quit doing wrong. Probably never going to be saved doing that way. But it's when you start getting rid of things, saying, God, I don't like this pig pen. And God says, look at that. Hey, angels, look at that. My spirit ain't in them yet, but look at them. They're coming after me. It's just in my mind, but I wondered how he knowed which way was home. He was far away in a strange city, strange country. Anybody ever felt far away in a strange country? But he always knew which way home was. Do you know which way home is today? It's so good to have Brother Lawrence with us. Hallelujah. Can't get that mic on, but I don't know why. Brother Ivy, get this. I don't know if it's on up there. Yeah, there it is. Praise the Lord. Smile. Be happy. Rejoice. You know, it takes more muscles to frown than it is to smile. Praise God. That's Little Miles. We all need to learn from Brother Little Miles. Busted head, and he walks around. He probably even smiles when he gets a whooping. See, it's in the nature of a man to be happy. Be happy today. Come on, brother.
Hallelujah. Somebody lift up your hands and your voice to the Lord today. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Such a sweet Spirit of God in this place today. I wish Lambert would have just kept on. I have not discussed one thing with him about what I'm preaching. I don't say this in an arrogant way because there's no good thing in me. But if I ever felt like I've heard from God for this church, offer from God today. Give honor to Brother Lambert, Sister Lambert. And try to say this without being emotional. But I got a surprise last week I wasn't expecting. I was at home, not feeling well. My phone dinged. And I got notified that you precious people had sent a love offering to the Lawrence family. I lost it. I cried and cried and cried. Not tears of sadness, but I was deeply moved. I couldn't even call Brother Lambert to tell him thank you. But from the bottom of our heart, the Lord's family. And I feel like this is so shallow, but I want to tell this church publicly, thank you so much. Thank you for loving us, for being there for us. You just got a knack for going above and beyond. And I appreciate it so very much. Acts chapter 12. I'm not going to be very long today. The Lord's moving in this house. While you're turning, Brother Lambert was talking about your mind. For the last 3 months, my family and I went through a severe trial. And I just refused to my wife. I said, we're not defeated. We're going through a trial, but we're not defeated. We're coming out of this. And of course, in the natural, when you miss work a lot due to sickness and different things, you get concerned about losing your job. Last week, I texted my boss. I got his personal number. I said, the doctors released me to come back to work on the 26th. Got a phone call. I thought, looked down, it was my boss calling me at the oh, boy. Answered the phone. I said, yes, sir. He said, got some news for you. It's so good, I couldn't text you. I had to call you. I said, what is it? He said, you just got a $2.65 an hour raise. And so, I said, but have you heard from Unum? He said, it doesn't matter what Unum says. We're not letting you go. We depend on you a lot. And he said, if you'll prove that you could hold up to the task of this new position, he said, I'm giving you a promotion. Got to get your mind right. Acts 12, verse 1. Now about that time, Herod the king stretched forth his hands to vex certain of the church. I'm not going to read. I'm going to skip down to verse 14. Bible says Peter's knocking at the door, and when she knew Peter's voice, she opened not the gate for gladness, but ran in and told how Peter stood before the gate, and they said unto her, "Thou art mad." But she constantly affirmed, "No, I'm not mad. I know what I heard. It's Peter. It's even so. It's Peter." And they said, "Well, it's his angel." But Peter continued knocking. When they had opened the door and saw him, they were astonished. I want to preach by the help of the Lord for just a few short minutes today. Vexed, but still victorious. Oh, somebody's going to come out today. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You can be seated in Jesus' name. We are in spiritual warfare. Matter of fact, I grew up all my life in church, and I've never seen the onslaught of hell like I've seen come against the ministry and families and churches and trying to wear us out. And the Bible talks about, even in the last days, that the enemy would come and try to wear out the saints of the Most High. Health problems and financial problems and struggles and family issues, and you could name it. All kinds of things are hitting the people of God. He's doing everything he can, and I'm not here to encourage or lift him up, but we are in a real battle today. He's doing everything he can to get our minds so focused and distracted until we start, as Pastor said earlier, believing a bunch of lies. How do you know the devil's lying? It's just simple. When he talks, it's a lie. The devil's never going to tell you anything true. If he tells you you're a loser, it's not time to hang your head. It's time to hold your head up and say, "Well, praise God. Devil, you said I'm a loser, so I must be a winner." Devil tells this church, "You're not going to have revival." Well, praise God. We're about to have a mighty apostolic revival. "You're not going to be healed." I've heard that for 16 years. With this leg problem. "Hey, devil, I'm still here. And not only that, God's gonna heal me." Vexed, vexed, vexed. He tries to wear out our minds. He tries to discourage us. We can't see Canaan for Jericho walls. And we can't see deliverance for the Red Sea. And we can't see open doors for the prison cells. But can I tell you this morning that there is a God that is on his throne. He's got a scepter in his hand. And he's got it extended. And God is about to show up. And God's about to show out. Because I'm telling you, God is not going to have a defeated church. God's not going to have a defeated people. I've come to preach to Solid Rock this morning. You are victorious. You are a revival church. You are having a breakthrough. You are going to see deliverance. You are going to see the power and the glory of God. Here the apostle Peter is. He's in this jail cell. They had killed James. Herod saw it pleased the Jews so much that he apprehended Peter and put him in prison too. And Peter, he's doing something that probably some of us wouldn't do. He's between soldiers. He's locked in a cell. And they got a 24-hour watch on him. He's not biting his fingernails. He's not sitting there thinking, boy, I tell you what, get my lawyer, we'll do a plea bargain. What you doing, Peter? I'm going to take a nap. I think it's a good time for a little R&R. I've been pretty busy here lately, so I think it's a good time for R&R. How can you relax? You're in a jail cell, and Herod's going to kill you at Easter. He's going to kill you. He's not only killing James, but he's out to kill you. How can you sleep in the middle of what you're going through? I don't know so much about what Herod's going to do. But I know what Jesus said. And Jesus told me, when thou shalt be old. I'm not an old man yet. So in the middle, I don't know when deliverance is coming, but I know it's coming. So I'm just going to sleep and relax. I'm not going to let the enemy torment me. I'm not going to let the enemy rob me. I'm just going to get a little R&R. You know what? I wonder what would happen if some of us, so much anxiety. We have restless nights. The enemy wants us to worry. He wants us to be stressed out. He wants us to give him glory. When you worry, you're giving him glory. But I wonder what would happen. I can just picture the enemy in a corner somewhere. And he's laughing because there's some of us that's worried to death. They don't believe God. They say they have faith. They say they revival church. Look at them. They're biting their nails. They're shaking in their shoes. But he's scanning the audience. Uh-oh. There's Brother Tom. Now I'm worried about that one. While these others over here are biting their nails and they're worried over this, that, and the other. I could just see Sister Deaver roll over on your side. While you sleeping, Yeah, it may look like I'm sleeping on a pillow, but I'm resting on a promise. It may look you wake up in the morning, and instead of saying, boy, I wonder how it's all going to work, praise him, praise him. I'm worried about that one. He acts like he believes God's going to do something at his church. He just acts like God's going to bring the backslider back. He just acts like he believes what pastor's been preaching. The devil don't worry so much about the worry warts. But when you start resting in the promises of God, when you start standing on the word of God, when you start believing the word of God, he don't like that, because he knows that without faith it's impossible to please God. But if you got faith and you please God, God shows up. God moves. God opens doors. God makes a way. I can just imagine the conversation between the soldiers. This guy's a snorer. Yeah. Would you mind rolling him over? I can't sleep. I can't sleep because he's sleeping. He's the one that should be worried and awake, and we're awake, and they're watching this guy, and he's just sleeping. What you doing, Peter? I'm dreaming of revival. Even in the prison, when your mind's right, the devil can't stop you dreaming. I'm dreaming of a breakthrough. I'm dreaming of loved ones coming in the church. I'm dreaming of a bigger church. I'm dreaming of a bigger youth group. I'm dreaming of a bigger attendance. You know why? I'm resting on a promise. And while he's sleeping, somebody enters the room. Walking right through the bars. Finds old Peter. Hey, Peter. Get up quickly. It's time to come out of this. And when he got up, the chains fell off. But Lord, I'm bound. I don't understand. Yeah, you're bound because you're not getting up. Oh, yeah, it's good to clap your hands. It's good to say amen every once in a while. But when I'm telling you, you get up, the chains have come off. How many times have we heard, and I've been here several times, and I've heard this man right here, get up in your mind, get up in your soul, get up in your spirit. Uh-huh. You know why? Because he knows if the church will get up, there ain't no bondage that could stop you. Ain't no prison wall that could stop you. Ain't no prison cell that could stop you. Church, get up. Church, get up. Church, get up. Brother Lawrence, I'm facing a trial. Yeah, you may be vexed, but greater is he that's in you than he that's in the world. I'm telling somebody today, victory's here. Your victory's here. Your victory's here. You may be went through a trial, but I'm telling you, you're victorious. You're victorious. You're victorious. You're victorious. You're victorious. Who is it? It's Peter. Peter who? I'm the pastor. Let me in the church. And she's hearing everybody interceding. Oh, God, please, Lord, save Peter. Get him out of the situation he's in. And she is so beside herself. Do I answer the door? Hey, guys, I hate to interrupt the prayer meeting. But the answer's at the door. Yeah. There were some in the churches kind of like some of us. You're mad. I haven't seen it yet. You're crazy. You think. I'm telling you guys, Peter's at the door.
Feel the Holy Ghost today.
Could it be that some of you that think you're waiting on the answer, maybe the answer is waiting on you to open the door?
What you doing? I'm waiting on God. One of these days, he's going to come through.
One of these days, he's going to give me that miracle I'm praying for. Let me in. Hey, let me in. Come on. I'm your breakthrough. I'm your revival. Come on. I'm your miracle. Come on. I'm the way where there seems to be no way. Let me in.
That Sister Lambert, she's mad. She just believes that God could do anything. I'll believe it when I see it.
Good luck. Because we walk by faith and not by sight. I'm telling somebody today, we're waiting on God to open the door sometimes, and God's waiting on us to open the door. There's doors that God opens, and then there's doors that we open. Let me in. Come on, let me in. Let me in.
Guys, I'm telling you, Peter's at the door.
You don't have to beg God. You don't have to plead with God. The answer's there. The answer's right here. Come on, church. Come on, open the door. Come on, the answer's there. The miracle's there. The breakthrough's there. I'm telling somebody today, you'll be astonished at how close the answer is. You'll be astonished at how close your revival is. You'll be astonished at how close your breakthrough is. But somebody's got to get up and somebody's got to go open that door. God's not going to do it for you. Your pastor can't do it for you. But it takes one man and one woman that'll stand up and say, you know what? I've been waiting long enough. I'm going to see what's on the other side. I'm going to see what's on the other side. I've been praying. I've been fasting. And I know God's got a victory for me. When they open the door, the very thing they've been praying for was on the other side. Let's lift our hands right now. I'm coming to a close. I feel the Holy Ghost in this place right now. Somebody needs to get you thinking right. Because the scripture says, as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. If you think thoughts of defeat, then you're going to be defeated. If you think thoughts of depression, you're going to be so depressed. But if you start thinking, God's able, God can. And we get that far. But let's go a step further. Yes, God's able. And yes, God can. But God will. Those children of Israel, those Hebrew children, they didn't sit there and say, well, God may. They were so, I'm telling you, their mind was so set. Their mind was so made up. They said, if we burn, we burn. But we're not bowing. And the God that we serve is able to deliver us out of your hand, O King. And he will deliver us. My question this morning is, what you gonna say when you're looking at the flames? There wasn't no possibility, Brother Deaver. They wasn't in a court and then they was gonna get let out. No, they were looking at the furnace. You bow, or that's the outcome. But they kept their mind right. Got through in. Hey, Captain, I got a question for you. Did not we cast 3 men into that fire? You speak the truth, okay? Yeah. Why am I seeing 4? See, when you got your mind right, and your mind may, even the fire can't stop you. It just literally refines you. And they walked out of that furnace, and the king said, he goes from bowing before the image and talking big. I can almost see him on his knees singing, praise the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. For there is no other God that can deliver after this sort. Deliverance is based on getting your mind right. Stand with me today. As long as you let the enemy have control, he'll play a game that you can't win. But the moment you switch hands and say, God, I'm not giving the enemy any room no more. I'm giving you the controls of my life. I'm giving you the control of my mind. I'm not living in defeat anymore. I'm not living discouraged anymore. But I'm living on the side of victory. I'm living on the side of a breakthrough. I feel the Holy Ghost falling in this place right now. Whew. Can I say this, and I'm not being unkind, church? I got a question for you. How long are you going to live beneath your means? How long are you going to live with our four no more? Do you realize who you are today? Do you really realize who you are? You're children of the Most High God. You got royal blood flowing through your veins. You got the Holy Ghost. It's time to get up. It's time to get up. It's time. Start baptizing people again. It's time to start having full altars again. Woo! I prophesy to this church in the Holy Ghost right now. If you'll get up and you'll do what God is telling this church to do, and you'll make an effort for outreach, and you'll make an effort for prayer, not just a certain time a year, not just whenever special meetings. I'm telling this church in the Holy Ghost, if you'll make an effort, God's going to fill this place up. I'm telling you, you want a word from God, that's a word from God. This church, if you'll make an effort. You haven't seen the revival that you're about to see. Because there's a shaking in this community right now. And hell's nervous. Because there's people in this church that's waking up. There's people in this church. There's giants that's waking up. There's people in this church that says, you know what? I've been down too long. It's time for me to get up. I've let my mind wander, but it's time for me to bring every thought into captivity. Because God's got a purpose for the church. God's got a purpose for my family. God's got a purpose. I want to be a part of the revival that God has. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You feel this? You feel this? You feel this? There's something coming in this church. I'm telling you, I feel the Holy Ghost in this place. This may be a strange altar call, but I'm going to give an altar call this way. There's something knocking at the door of this church right now. You can talk about revival, and you can talk about yesteryear if you want to. But if you want the revival that God has for this church, and you really want it, and your mind's made up, you're going to have it, why don't you come and open that door? Why don't you step out and say, you know what? I'm not waiting on pastor. I'm not waiting on brother so-and-so. I'm not waiting on sister so-and-so. I'm not waiting for the right drum beat. It's time for a miracle. It's time for a breakthrough. It's time to live in perpetual victory. Come on, hold your head up. Come on, hold your head up. You ain't got to beg for the promises of God. God wants you to have it. Open the door, Rhoda. Open the door, Rhoda. I'm standing at the door, Rhoda. Come on, open the door. The very thing you've been praying for, Rhoda, is right there. The very victory you've been hoping for is right there. The very breakthrough you've been hoping for is right there. Let's talk to the Lord. Let's talk to the Lord.
I'm gonna see victory. I'm gonna see victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. I'm gonna see victory. I'm gonna see victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. I'm gonna see victory. I'm gonna see victory. For the
you turn it for good.
see a victory, for the battle belongs to you, Lord.
Yes! 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 Glory! peace, God. Bring peace. Bring peace, Lord Jesus. Hear her cry, oh God. Know her heart, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. There is a danger in waking up but not getting up. I said there's a danger in waking up but not getting up. There's times that I have gotten wake up to get up, but I thought I'd just lay there a few more minutes to only realize I fell back asleep. But it's when you get up, the danger of going back to sleep is pushed a long ways away. Every time the Lord healed someone that was in a bed, He never told them, stay in the bed. But He said, take up your bed. If you'll get up, God's got a great future for you. But the Bible warns us of sleeping the sleep of death. You got to get up out of that bed. Get up out of that affliction. Get up out of those problems. And when Peter got up, everything that they put on him fell off. I'm going to tell you, everything the enemy puts on you only works if you lay there. But the promise today is if you'll get up, it'll fall off. I want us to lift our hands to the Lord today. You on the internet, the enemy wants to keep you in a prison. He wants you to stay in the prison in your mind. He wants you to believe a lie. But I'm going to tell you today, the Bible said the truth shall set you free. If you'll get up, quit believing everything everybody else tells you. Believe what God says. It'll fall off. And what you thought you couldn't get victory over will be laying at your feet. Hallelujah. Oh, somebody clap your hands to the Lord today. Hallelujah. Where's Sister Rhoda at? Where's Sister Rhoda? Gotta open the door. Gotta open the door, Jacob. Do you want to be a heat and air man all your life? Well, get up. If you'll get up in your spirit, you'll get up, and all the things you think you can't let go of fall off. it will. Hallelujah. You may be seated today. Everybody smiling? I'll be up again. Just you wait and see. Ain't no grave gonna hold him. I was at Ryan's yesterday for a little while, and I don't know where it came from. We was talking, and I was pulling off, and I said, the Lord only needed the tomb for the weekend. That's all he needed it. Because there was a coming up time. And you got to have a coming up time. Praise God. You might be 5'4", but you know what? In the spirit, you can be 10 foot. Praise God. Let's remember all the hurting, all the sick, the afflicted. Let's remember revival. Praise God. God moving, God stirring. Hallelujah. Remember our conference coming up. It got up there. Man, it does my heart good to see every time I go to Facebook. Every time I flip, I see it there. Just make it solid. Just blow it up. Put it on 500 times a day. Praise God that Facebook calls you and says, what's going on? Praise the Lord. You got my permission. Glory to God. I want to look and see it on there. Every time I see it, I'm going to put a penny in your bank account. Praise God. Hallelujah. Where's Brother Ivy at today? Could you come down here for a little while? Praise God. Could you come down here for a little while? We was going to have a pounding and want to pound you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Oh, I'm ready for cooler weather. I'm not saying cold weather. Cooler. So when it gets too cold, e.g., don't go outside. Unless it's in my tractor or I got some heat. Come on up here. You had a birthday last week, didn't you? Are you 16? Huh? Wow. 16. You remember being 16? You don't? I remember it. It was a good year. Right. 15 was a good year. Got my first truck when I was 15. I remember 10 years old. I remember when I was born. Praise. Anybody remember when you were born? Praise the Lord. That nurse thought I was the cutest baby it was. This is birthday. Last week, what day? Thursday. Praise God. And he went camping on that night, didn't you? How did it turn out? Yeah. Sent me a picture of him camping, had a tent on top of the back of his truck. I said, thank God for motels. I like air conditioning. But Brother Ivy, we love you. And hallelujah. We know how much you've been wanting to go to Disney. And so we had got you some gas money to go to the Disney store. Praise God. You can get you a stuffed animal. That's the best kind. You don't have to feed them, clean them, wash them, pick up behind them. You put them in a corner and they stay there till you get them back up. But We appreciate you and all you've done for this church. And it's just a small token. Praise God. It's just the smallest token I could find. Praise God. We're going to sing happy birthday to him. How old are you?
58.
58. Man, you're just a young whippersnapper. 58. Praise God. We're going to sing to him. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Ravi. Happy birthday to you. We love Brother Ivy. Hallelujah. I'm not used to singing that one. Hallelujah. I'm used to singing, happy, happy birthday. We so glad you came. Happy, happy birthday from the Lambert gang. Praise the Lord. Praise God. But love Brother Ivy, I tell you. I love all his family. Maybe not Dusty, but Dusty's got some great kids. Praise the Lord. Just glad they took after his mother. Praise God. And that little one used to always be scared of me. So she came to my house one day, and we had just gotten a big old box of gummies, bears and bags. She went at least 5 times and got a bag and brought it to me, and I opened it. And she brought number 6, and I said, baby, I said, I want to be your friend, but I can't give you no more of them. Ever since, she's liked me, praise God. Ushers, come on up today. Let's remember Wednesday night service. It's going to be grown-up children's service. You know, I hate to introduce children's church because sometimes the older people think, well, it's children's church, I don't have to be there. You know what? If children are here supporting you in big church, you need to be here in little church supporting them. Praise the Lord. I love our children. Hallelujah. Putting something in them to give them hope in a world of no hope. Praise God. Hallelujah. Appreciate having our visitors. Really not visitors. Praise God. They're just travelers. Praise God. Appreciate Nick, isn't it? Brother Nick. Praise God. From Shamat. I just don't understand how he can bring a dog and don't bring us some gumbo. Praise God. You know, we could love the dog a little more if we had some gumbo. Appreciate him and Sister Pam's guest there. Praise the Lord. Heather, Sister Heather, she's really not a guest, but we love her and love everybody. Praise God. Let's all stand. We're going to pray over the offering. Tithes. Lord, we come before your throne today, calling upon your name. We ask, Lord, to touch this offering, touch the tithes, touch the church, that we can fulfill the purpose which we are called in this hour. In Jesus' mighty name, everybody.